by Jim's Test and Tag.
And welcome back to the Jim's Test and Tag match of the round. It's players are gearing up, ready to get back into their positions. And we thank Michael Voss, who sent us a halftime score. He's at the Mornington versus Seaford game. And the Dogs are up 6-8-44 to Seaford, 2 goals, 3-15. So doing the job there by 29 points at the moment, the Doggies. So thanks to Vossi for providing us with that score. Here at the Jim's Test and Tag match of the day, it's Crib Point 3-3-21 trailing Pearsdale at halftime, 4 goals, 7-31. And we're joined by Geordie King and Adam Shortpass Kelly, and we're just about to start play in this second half. Umpire holds the ball aloft and we're away. So it's Pearsdale, like they did in the first quarter, went straight into attack. Becker, handball off to Pat Cab. Pat Cab kicks the ball out wide. That's a great start once again from Pearsdale. That centre clearance, and inside 15 seconds, Pat Hayden's got the footy in his hands, and he'll have a shot for goal from about 35, 40 metres out from.
Shouldn't have a problem with distance here, Towie. Great kick of the footy.
Hasn't kicked a goal this afternoon, Pat Hayden. Needs to kick it. Needs to kick a couple. So it's a nice-looking kick off the boot. He's got the journey. It's a great start for the Dales. They draw first blood in the second half. They move to 5 goals, 7-37. Crib Point, 3-3-21. 16 points the difference.
Great start. Exactly what Pearsdale would have wanted, but not what the Magpies would have wanted here, Towie, in the nest. They really need to bounce back to make it a good contest. Can't let it slip away here. Obviously, Pearsdale sitting on 5th at the moment and Magpies on 7th. So, yeah, they really need to lift their heads up and kick the next goal.
So we're back in the centre of the ground again. It's James Cook up against Benny Mitchell. This time Mitchell got the tap. There he is again. Pat Cad needs to get the handball out. He does. Looking for a Vard, but chopped off. That was by Davidson, I think it was. Went up towards half forward. Great work there by Clark to bring the ball to ground. And the ball eventually goes over the line and out of bounds.
Really want to eat the last bit of that hot dog,
Yeah, I'm sure you do. We'll just eat it. Go for it. Inhale it. Smells too good for me not to be eating it. So the ball comes in half forward. They dive on top of it. Could have been a free kick there against Danny Edwards. The umpire said no. Wade Symes, Kingy, in this third quarter. Is he out there?
Haven't seen him, so I don't think so.
Still, there's only three on the interchange bench, so he must be done for the day as the ball comes in again. Ben Cad snaps it over his shoulder up towards the wing position. Brad Davidson goes back with it, sliding in there. Few players. Paddy Cad gets his left foot to it, kicks it up towards half to the wing position. Fortnum falls over, gets one in the back, and geez, luck's a fortune, isn't it? Because he got one fair and square in the back, but he slipped over at the critical time. He's got a fair bit of claret on the back of those shorts too, as he goes across the face of goal. Oh. Ben Mitchell, I think he opened his gob and tried to eat that one, because I think it hit him in the mouth as the ball goes up towards full forward for the ball. They need to work here. The Magpies comes down there towards Jake Bromley. Little left foot kick around the corner, looking for carries. Wants to keep it in, does so now. He's got someone inside. Wasn't the greatest of handballs though. Put his teammate there in Pemberton. Buchanan under pressure up towards full forward again. Pearsdale going back with a fly to the ball, chopped off by Becker. Another one there towards Hensby, has a shot for goal and he's kicked it. Great work there by Pearsdale. Just sloppy defensive work there by the Magpies allowed Pearsdale to kick goal number 6. So they move on to 6 goals, 7-43. Crib Point 3-3-21. And as they've been able to do in the opening two quarters, kick the first 2 goals of the quarter.
Absolutely, which really damages the Magpies as they try and move forward. They just need to contest that footy, as you said, Towie, that just sloppy work by Magpies defence then. Had the opportunity to get the ball out, but shocking kick and resulted in a goal.
Well, you just get the feeling, don't you, that if Pearsdale can kick another one, it'll be all over and an avalanche might begin. Because Crib Point season is on the line. They lose this game and any finals chances that they had before coming into the game will be completely shot. As Adam Avard, he actually had it spent before he picked it up. He keeps it going in front of him. Eventually, the ball goes over the line and out of bounds. And Brad Davidson just starting to run with the dreadlocks now, I think. I see a hint there of dreadlocks on I'm Brad Davidson.
Yeah, I think you might be right there, Towie. I think he just needs to wash his hair too, to be honest.
As the ball gets dived on, there it is. It's Fortnum. Didn't get a free kick on that one. And Andre Agassi, who's umpiring this game, is coming in to throw the ball up, giving the tennis away after a couple of Wimbledon wins. Good work there by Andre as he throws the ball up. Lost sight of where he was on that occasion. It's like he's having a little toe poke for goal, and he was looking for touch. This man definitely has dreadlocks. It is Luke Harrington. Kicks the ball up towards inside 50. They fly. Mitchell couldn't take the mark. Good work there by Clark. He's been good for them across half forward today. Diving on top of the ball. That was Dwayne Bowes. Eventually comes out to Carey's. Carey's to Fleck. Fleck just taps it along the ground. Then able to get rid of his opponent. He's trying to beat a couple there now. Luke Murray. But eventually the ball gets held in. And there'll be a boundary. Not a boundary thrown, but there'll be a ball up. About 15 metres out directly in front.
Desperate footy by Pierce Dale then, just to keep it locked in.
It was. Big sloper. He tried to grab the ball out of the ruck. It's kicked out there by Cad. Kicked up towards half-back. Davidson takes the mark. Kicks the ball inside now. Needs a mark, but standing firm is Andrew Douglas. And Andrew Douglas takes the mark. Left foot kick goes out wide, looking for Becker. Becker takes the mark, defensive 50, outer side of the ground for the Dales. They lead 6-7-43, crib point 3-3-21. 22.2 points the difference. We've played 5.5 minutes. Ball's on the outer wing position. They all dive on top of it. Nobody can get it out. And eventually the umpire will come in and bounce.
It's a dirty side of the ground over there, Towie. Wouldn't like to be rolling around in the stuff over there.
No. Danny Edwards is one of the last ones up from the bottom of the pack. Up they go. Good work there by Pat Cad. Just kicks it off the ground. Diving on top of it. That was really, really good work there by Jake Bromley. A lot of players overrunning the footy at the moment. Going in hard there. Handball. Left foot kick there. Come from Mitchell. Looking towards the boundary line. Eventually, both Sam Austin and Chris Hensby see it over the line and out of bounds. So we're still on the outer side of the ground. Just forward of the wing in favour of the Dales. They lead by 22 points. Not the greatest throw in there by the boundary umpire. Goes up towards the wing position. Ben Cadd, handball out. Just a big swat that was there from Ben Mitchell. He's hoping a teammate can run onto it. There's Paddy Hayden. He wants someone running past. It's Ben Cadd. Gets around far too easy. Flying shot at goal. Paddy Cadd should have done more with it on that occasion, but it's through for a minor score, so behind. So they extend their margin by yet another point. So the Magpies bring the ball back into play. Lawson, they all look at one another. Who's going to go for it? Davidson wanted Lawson. Lawson wanted Davidson. It allowed Avard to get in there. Pemberton Buchanan, he gets a little handball towards Lawson. Lawson with the left foot kick up towards half forward. Screaming out for the footy there. That was good by Bromley. Comes to Austin. Ooh. Austin gets a little handball. Adams it is, not Austin. Austin out of this contest this afternoon through suspension that he copped last week against Devon Meadows in a retaliation. So Andre Agassi, the umpire, he's got the ball again, throws it up, half forward for the Magpies. They've just got to kick the next goal. Cook, that's James Cook, kicks it up towards full forward. They need a runner to go onto it. That's Cunliffe. He went for the left foot hack off the ground, but it's sprayed across the face through for a minor score.
Was better off picking it up then, Towie. He had a little bit of room. Ball bounced up nicely. Could have picked it up and had a better chance at goal.
So we're at full back. It'll be Travis Saw to kick the ball back into play. Still raining outside. So the ball comes out towards half back there for Pierce Dale. Great mark there by Benny Mitchell.
Mark Mitchell.
Stood up and took the mark nicely, the big fella. Been playing well this afternoon. Wants to go short, looking for and finding his teammate.
Great kick,
good handball.
Right off.
Wasn't a great handball though from Becker. Puts Adam Avard under pressure. Fortnum comes out. Becker wants it back. Fortnum gets around onto that left foot. Kicks it looking for Vag. Jansons goes for it now. Almost took the mark. Pulled off it by Flack. Dylan Hall. He gets tackled. James Cook, terrific. Lawson, another possession. Goes towards Edwards, just tapping it in front of himself. Wants the boundary line. Doesn't want it. All of a sudden, he gets it. And the ball goes over the line and out of bounds.
I think at this stage, Towie, definitely into this quarter, we're at the 8-minute, 9-minute mark. And I think Crib Point just being a little bit too cute. They need to rush the ball rather than just start, you know, hand passing it around. I understand what they're trying to do, but it's not working for them.
So the ball comes up there towards the half back line, or the full forward line for Pearsdale, if you like, but seeing the ball over the line there was Shane Ainsworth. And about 60 metres around from goal, there'll be another boundary throw in.
Leading possession getter on the ground's now Pat Cadd, who's got 23 over Dave Lawson's, who has 22.
So he's doing it again, Pat Cadd.
Mm.
Can't possibly give him another gourmet on main and high on fruit award, could we?
Largest trophy in football.
It is. It would have been nice for Matty Sloper to win it, for the biggest trophy to go to the biggest number in football. Paddy Hayden looking for goal number two this afternoon. He's just missed it to the near side. He should have started at left, didn't start at two near right, and it stayed there. 6 goals, 9:45 to Crib Point, 3 goals, 4:22. So just the 2 goals in this quarter so far, both to Pearsdale, Chris Hensby and Pat Hayden. So we're just waiting for the footy to come back into play.
Just on the swings again.
Yeah, they are. He's just walking very gingerly behind the goals there.
Yeah,
that man.
No rush.
No rush at all. Must be a bit slippery down there just too. Just doesn't want to fall over. Yeah. Just climbing into the back of his car now. So just going back for a snooze, I think. As the ball comes out towards the defensive 50-metre line for Pearsdale, Dean Jansen's in there for Pearsdale. And getting up from the bottom of the pack there is Jake Bromley, who's having a pretty good quarter for Crib Point. The ball goes up again. Tapped out. Jansen just goes to the don't argue. Gives it out to Gamble. There's a free kick. It's going to be against... Agassi didn't like that
work. No, he didn't. Bet me to it, Towie.
So it goes to Carey. So Carey's goes short, looking for his long sleeve teammate there in Brad Davidson. Sold some candy there. That was nice
that was
work by
play.
Brad Davidson. Kicked the ball on the outside of his foot. Comes down there towards Flack. Needs some support. Gives it to Adams. Adams is in a bit of trouble there. Just gets a handball, hoping for the best. Troy Cunliffe's got to go. He's kicked a goal in the second quarter. Caleb Foggy's in there for Pearsdale. Comes out there towards Dwayne Bowes. Good work there by Cunliffe, but smothered by Foggy. And the ball goes over the line and out of bounds. Touched.
Quick legs, Foggy.
Left forward pocket for Pearsdale, or for Crib Point, in fact. They trail 3-4, 22 to 6-9, 45. 23 points the difference. Sam Adams runs over the footy. Little quick kick out, and it goes over the line. One bounce and out of bounds. So I think they were looking for a free kick. Jacob Cook was looking for a free kick there, but he's not going to get it. It just bounced before it went over the line and out of bounds. Little push there from Luke Murray.
Oh, great fend off. Oh, I nearly got his dreadlocks. Oh,
holding
Andre.
Holding the ball there against Luke Harrington, and it will go. Well, he's got hair envy, has has Andre Agassi. There from Pat Gamble.
Oh, he's down. A huge fly.
Somebody's down.
Davidson.
Davidson got a knee fair and square in the back of the head. The ball goes up towards the inside 50 once again for Crib Point. Byron Hose working hard down there. And eventually they all dive on top of the footy. And there'll be ball up about 25 metres out directly in front of Crib Point's goal. Up they go. Neil Clark, he got up high before he should have. Comes out looking for Gamble. Gamble's able. He just gets it flicked from him, though. Good work there by Dylan Hawke. Gave it towards Pat Cadd. Pat Cadd kicks the ball up towards half forward. Hayden a long
good
way
mark.
Out from goal. But there's Dick LaVere. Comes out and takes the mark at half back. So De Kluver represented Crib Point in interleague footy this year. Good young player. Controls the back half. Dave Lawson, his coach, very, very happy with him this season. The ball is on the ground. Pat Cadd gives it to Hoare. Hoare kicks it up there towards Vag. Vag held on to. The umpire said nothing. You know, eventually gives him the free kick, and that's against Jaden Eppenchild.
That's fair enough, Towie. Just over the shoulder punch away then and just... well spotted by the umpire then.
So Vag goes in short, just wants to bring him around on his mark. It's all a bit tuggy touchwood if you ask me.
It is, because he's not going to kick the goal from there, Towie.
No, he's not. He's only been moved around 2 metres, so inconsequential in the scheme of the game so far. As Vag went short, but then decides to go long, kicks it up there towards inside 50.
Andre's paid a free kick.
Yeah, he has paid a free kick, and it's against Pearsdale, and it'll go down there to De Kluver.
It's going to be interesting to see what they do here. Yep, nope, see, handball.
So went short, gets himself into trouble, carries, goes backwards. So they're just playing around with it a bit too much. A short pass, said Cook gets a quick kick up forward. Standing there was Jansen, bounced off his chest. Travis saw, got a little handball, almost got his head ripped off there. Was young Lockie Marshall. Little 360 tackle there from Adams. Comes down there towards Jake Bromley. He gives it off. Only as far as Saw. Saw gives it to Ben Cadd. Ben Cadd now kicks it upside half forward line, and coming out and taking a good mark there is Chris Fortnum. Goes back, got something short. Matthew Vagg goes and takes the mark, and he'll have a shot for goal from about 45, 50 metres out.
He's trying just to creep around to improve his angle, Towie, but decides to play on.
Goes short, and he finds Dylan Hoare, who's standing in the hole on his own.
Great vision then. Looked like he was going to go back and take a set shot, but Hall made himself available and now lines up from about 30 out on a slight angle. Shouldn't have a problem here.
So Hall to bring to extend the margin. Currently it's 23 points. This will blow it out to 29, and you can just about rest assured the crib point won't come back from there. So Dylan Hall was a fine player for Frankston YCW. That's sprayed. Not his best effort. He sprayed it across the face. So it's 6 goals, 10, letting him off the hook here, Pearce, at the moment.
Absolutely.
46 leading crib point, 3 goals, 4, 22. So the Magpies still alive.
There hasn't really been a cold kick, has there, Towie, for what, maybe 14,
yeah,
13 minutes?
Correct. They kicked 2 goals inside the first
straight
3.5 minutes.
Yeah, yeah. So, obviously, Pearsdale having a lot of the footy, but just the pressure from Crib Point's defence is, stopping them from scoring the majors, which is good to see.
Jacob Cook kicks the ball in, half forward. Ball spills towards the boundary line. Eventually, it goes over. So, half forward, still inside the half forward line for Pearsdale. Jacob Cook, it was a lovely kick out, but just got forced back inside the attacking zone for Pearsdale. As these two players go into battle again, this time it's James Cook who gets the better of Ben Mitchell. Little kick off the ground came from David Cook. Goes up there towards the big fella in Clark. He's been terrific this afternoon. Johnny Flack, he went to take the mark. Harrington's in the danger zone as well. I like them both in attack. Matthew Sloper's out there as well, but the ball gets stuck under the pack, and it'll be a ball up. Thanks to Jim's Test and Tag. Some stats. Inside 50s and clearances in this quarter, Kingy.
Inside 50s, Pearsdale's leading this quarter 9-4. And they're also leading the clearances 4-1.
And Brad Davidson's been given the benefit of the doubt there. He took the mark. And, it only dropped out when he hit the deck. No, you don't think?
No, look, I don't, Towie. It was a great pluck of the ball, one hand, but just didn't control it on the way down, and that's normally what you have to do in football.
So he gives it off to Jacob Cook, who's a beautiful kick of the footy. But
flyer
almost
at the back.
Took the mark. Was Sloper. The umpire said no, it's all through, all clear.
All clear for the point.
Through for a minor score. So the Magpies at least score in this final quarter.
They just need to lock it up here, Towie. Just build that wall across their forward 50 and just lock it in.
Travis Saw, I said in this final quarter, of course, the third quarter, as the ball goes out there towards the defensive 50. Dylan Hall laconically just handballs it off. Douglas has got the footy, left foot kick up towards the wing position. Andrew Knight running back with the flight of the ball. And eventually it goes over the line out of bounds right in front of, Matthew Bagg was the player that saw the ball over the line, right in front of the Pearsdale coach's box. So the ball back into play once again. Good work there by Mitchell. Harrington got the handball out. It was a look away, in fact. He wanted to give it back to Harrington, but he had Foggy on him. Good body work there by Saw. Comes down there towards Jonathan Flack. Handball inside, finds Adams. Adams now,
trouble.
Left foot kick up towards full forward. Coming out, couldn't take the mark there. That was Frost, I think it was. Might have also been Dwayne Bowes. Whoever's got it now, that's Becker, in fact. Kicks the ball up towards the wing position. But sliding in and taking a good mark there was Jake Cook. Cook goes up towards Flack, inside 50-metre line for Crib Point. They dive on top of it. Could have been a free kick given away. The umpire said, no, give it to me. I'll restart play.
Desperation footy for Crib Point. They need to kick the next goal. As you said, Towie, if they don't, it's going to be a walk away, which no one wants to see. All 203 people watching today's game, no one wants to see it. Nobody.
So the ball gets thrown in. Good work there by Hensby. Just trapped the footy. So Crib Pointer doing okay at the moment. Just holding the ball in. Luke Harrington, left foot kick inside 50. Big Betty Mitchell goes back. Only eyes for the footy. That was wonderful work by him. Gives it to Avard.
Deliberate.
Not sure it was deliberate, but certainly felt more pressure than was there on that occasion. Adam Avard had a lot more time to pick that footy up and clear.
Yeah, it was probably a bit too quick, wasn't it, Toey? He had a bit of time and, just sprayed off the boot and lucky it didn't go out in the full, really.
So Adams, one of the shortest players on the ground, was third man up. Umpire says there's a free kick and it's going to James Cook.
Well, I think they lifted him, Toey, just rugby union style. To get him up there. Headbutt it with his helmet.
Gives it to Jacob Cook. Left foot kick inside. Just plenty of wall, plenty of numbers there for Pearsdale. It's a free kick. It'll go Pearsdale's way. And it's going to go down there towards Chris Hensby, who's been very, very good in this game of footy. Wants to come out wide. Mitchell's got three to beat. He goes up the big fella. Almost pulled it down. The umpire gave him the benefit of the doubt and paid the mark. So Ben Cadd and Sam Adams just having a bit of a how do you do, if you like.
Yeah.
James Cook and Ben Mitchell also having a little bit to say to one another. So Ben Mitchell, one of the best players on the ground, in for mine, just kicks it up
the
line.
Out of
bounds in the full. Kicks it out of bounds in the full. So just undid all his good work then, big Manny Mitchell. So the free kick will go down there towards Harrington. They need a few of him on the field at the moment, Luke Harrington.
I was just about to say that, Toey. He's definitely the best at the moment for Crib Point.
Goes up towards... He went short. Matthew Vag's got some numbers inside. Goes towards Adam Avard. Floats the ball. Not his greatest effort. Chipping in and taping the mark there is Jacob Cook. So Jacob Cook looking to slow the play down. He needs to speed the play up.
He was walking back, Toey, like he was about to take a kick for goal. Needs to really speed it up. Get Pearsdale by surprise.
Luke Harrington copped one around the neck. The umpire said there was nothing. Nothing in it.
Andre Agassi, that's tough. He definitely has an issue with Harrington because of his hair.
It's hair envy. That's exactly what it is. So Harrington just shaking his head and smiling. He doesn't know what the hell the free kick was for, but there's Mitchell. I reckon he's kicked it out of the ball again.
I reckon that was tight.
Anyway, they got the free kick. Big James Cook's been terrific. Gives
Captain.
It out there towards Jake Bromley. Kicks the ball up towards Adams. Thumped away from him by Dwayne
Bowes.
And the ball goes over the line and out of bounds. So there'll be a boundary throw in. Half forward for the Magpies. How are they going with their inside 50s, Kingy?
Inside 50s, Pearsdale leading 9-8.
Okay, so Crib Point starting to get back into the contest in terms of their inside 50s. Certainly not making the most of it, though. They've only booted two behinds in this quarter.
Yeah.
Pearsdale have added two goals, three.
A lot of numbers around the footy, Toey.
There are. They suit Pearsdale at the moment. Just holding the ball up.
Yeah.
Good work there by Mitchell. Got the ball out. Gave it out there towards Hensby.
Handball.
Hensby goes in short. Got dealt with when he got rid of the footy. Should have got a free kick for down the field. The umpire said no. Plenty of players just diving on top of the footy. And I reckon on that occasion, the big fella in Hayden was happy just to see the ball over the line and out of bounds.
So just in Pearsdale's attacking 50. What they need.
Yeah, they do. They'll be looking to put a nail in the coffin here as the free kick's been plucked out there by the umpire, Andre Agassi. Goes to Cook. Goes to another Cook. Is there any other Cooks in the kitchen? No. The ball goes out there towards Davidson.
I knew that was going
to
happen.
Got one in the back. Adam Avard just trying to keep the ball. Needed to keep his feet on that occasion. Sam Adams gets fenced there by Andrew Douglas. And the ball goes over the line and out of bounds. So it's half forward for Crib Point. 3-5-23, Pearsdale, 6 goals, 10-46. We've called much more exciting games this season. Comes down towards Luke Harrington. Harrington gets tackled. The minute he gets his hands on the footy, he gets held up, and the umpire said, give it to me, we'll throw the ball up. I reckon the rain is gone. No rain to speak of here at Crib Point anymore. The lights are off.
The lights are off, as you mentioned at halftime, Toey. People around Crib Point need to start putting the stoves on, ready for a Saturday roast. So just got to turn the lights off. Make sure there's plenty of power to the homes of Crib Point, Toey.
Correct. As Dave Lawson snaps it around the corner, looking for Slope. A good mark there by... That was Lee Clark. Just threw him around like a rag doll.
That was aggressive.
Sam Austin kicks the ball up towards full forward. The ball spills.
Nah.
No. Through for a minor score. So they're peppering Crib Point at the moment. Or certainly attacking, but just
definitely
can't get
attacking.
The results. 3-6, 24 to 6-10, 46. Back to 22 points the difference. We've played almost 24 minutes into the third quarter.
They just need to tighten up here, Crib Point, and force contested marks and possessions to be able to get possession of the ball. So it's not happening.
It's not. The ball comes out. Everyone's diving on top of it. Eventually, it's Shane Ainsworth, happy just to see the ball over the line out of bounds, right in front of the Whiston stand.
Whiston!
It is TF Whiston. Crib Point change rooms it is. Good work there. Oh, that was a great roving attempt. Only as far as Byron Ho, who gets the ball for Pearsdale, kicks it up there towards the wing position. Little handball gave towards Dylan Hoare.
They're on
here. He thought about a bounce in the middle of the ground. That's a shocking effort there by Hoare. And a second effort wasn't good either. Should have bent over and picked the footy up. Matthew Vagg just with his hands in the air, hands over the back of his head saying, geez, I was 30 metres on my own. All you need to do was clip it over and I couldn't do it.
Just chip it over.
That's all he needed to do there. Couldn't do it. Comes out there towards Cook. Cook with a little tap over the back. Good work there by Jake Bromley. Gave a handball out. They dive on top of it. Hensby's going to get a free kick here against just David Cook. No.
He has. No.
He has.
He's dropping the ball.
Holding the footy. David Cook wasn't keen on getting rid of the footy at all.
No. No. It was hatching it.
He was. And Chris Hensby will take the free kick on the outer wing. Goes short. Shocking kick. Found Carey's. Carey's for Crib Point. Goes to Harrington. He doesn't know what to do with the ball either at half back. Goes across the face. And the Magpies are able to maintain possession of the footy across half back. No one to go to. No one presenting for Crib Point. Once again, they're forced to go short. This time
back
it's Luke Harrington.
This time and every other time, he's just unbelievable. Just made himself available across the ground. He's able to create play by dragging his players down ground. Fantastic player.
David Cook kicks it across the face, across half forward. Jonathan Flack comes out, couldn't take the mark. Pearsdale got some numbers back. Matthew Vagg looks like he's a long, long way away from home playing defence at the moment. The ball comes out towards Luke Murray. He gets ridden in the back. There was Becker.
Oh,
finally,
that
a little
was
quick
good
kick
smother.
Comes out. Caleb Cray, I think it is, kicks it up towards full forward, bouncing. They want to see a behind Pearsdale, and they're able to do that. Just force the ball over the line and through for a minor score. For the Magpies, 3 goals, 7, 25. Pearsdale, 6 goals, 10, 46. Haven't been able to kick a goal in this third quarter. Crib Point. Ball comes out there towards Douglas. He goes in hard.
Lawson's got
to
go.
Keeps his head over the footy. Gives it to Avard. Avard again. Just kicks the ball forward. Didn't even look at him, Avard. And he's really let himself down in this third quarter as the ball goes up towards the wing position. Pat Gamble almost again took a sensational mark. Plenty of players around the footy now. Good defensive work by the Magpies. And umpire Andre Agassi will come in and bounce the ball yet again.
He's got the tattoos on his wrist as well.
And there's the siren. 27 minutes the quarter went for. A really uneventful quarter of football it was. And we'll go to a break and we'll be back with a three-quarter time wrap. You're listening to RPP, the voice of Peninsula Football.
One of the fastest growing sports in the Western world today is mixed martial arts. Learn self-defense and be fit with Australia's original mixed martial art, Zendo Kai. Teaching modern principles on a foundation of karate, Zendo Kai has training for kids, teenagers and adults in a great atmosphere. Call Zendo Kai Mornington Peninsula, 9982466. That number again, 9982466. Zendo Kai Mornington Peninsula, our station sponsor.
When you're working in the garden, you need tough, reliable tools that won't let you down. That's why Hastings mowers stock quality brands like Honda, Echo, Toro, Cox, Husqvarna and Shindaiwa, with a huge range of mowers, brush cutters, chainsaws, shredders, pumps and generators in store. For quality equipment and excellent service, call into our sponsor Hastings Mowers Superstore at 2013 Frankston Flinders Road, Hastings.
Cats, PFM sponsor.
Gold medal swimmer and victim of electric shock.
In 2007, I suffered a severe electric shock in a workplace accident, something I never want to experience again. I am now committed to electrical safety in the workplace and the services provided by Jim's Test and Tag. Jim's Test and Tag will test your workplace electrical equipment for faults and assist with your compliance to OH&S.
Jim's Test and Tag.
Gold medalist in electrical safety.
Call 131 Jim. That's 131-546. Or log on to jimstestandtag.com.au.
And welcome back to the RPPFM Match of the Day. Brought to you by Jim's Test and Tag.
Oh yes, and welcome back to the Jim's Test and Tag Match of the Round. It's Crib Point versus Pearsdale, and she's a pretty uneventful game here, to be completely honest with you. Pearsdale, 6 goals, 10-46, leading Crib Point, 3 goals, 7-25. 21 points the difference. Pearsdale added 2 goals, 3 in that quarter. Crib Point added just the 4 behinds. Goal kickers, there was 2 goal kickers in that quarter. Pat Hayden and Chris Hensby booted 1 each. 2 goals to Gavin Becker, kicked him 1 in the first quarter, 1 in the second. Andrew Douglas has 1, Matthew Vag has 1 as well. And for Crib Point, Troy Cunliffe kicked a goal in the second quarter. Luke Harrington and Neil Clark both kicked goals in the opening quarter. But other than that, there hasn't been a lot of joy for the Magpies. Thanks to Jim's Test and Tag, let's throw to Kingy, who's going to give us all the statistics of the players that we've been watching in the first three quarters of footy.
Dave Lawson for Crib Points had 24. He only had the 4 touches that quarter. John Flax had 13. Luke Harrington, 13. And Brad Davidson, 10. Pearsdale, Chris Hensby's had 17, Ben Cadd 13, Andrew Douglas 11, Chris Fortnum 15, Dylan Hoare 13, and Pat Cadd 24. Inside 50s, it is Pearsdale 30 to Crib Points 27, and clearances 22 to 11. Pearsdale is dominating that.
Yeah, and that's probably the difference between the two sides at the moment, I think, is their ability to get the ball away from stoppages. And the defensive work, too, has been fantastic, led by Tom Frost has been fantastic down there. Byron Ho's been good. Travis Saw as well for Pearsdale. Dwayne Bowes has been working hard as well. So they've got plenty of good players playing, Luke Murray as well. So their back six at the moment have been very, very good, and their midfield defence has been fantastic as well. So they get down there and really support their defenders out. Crib Point, on the other hand, just can't penetrate. They're not getting the ball inside 30 at the moment. Most of their shots are being from outside range, and on a cold, wet day, it's been very, very difficult for them to get the journey.
Correct.
Best players up until this stage, for mine, John Flack has played 3 good quarters of footy, and Luke Harrington, probably the only 2 players in my mind that have played 3 good quarters of footy for Crib Point. Dave Lawson's been terrific, as Geordie King said, thanks to Jim Seston Tag. He was a little quieter in that third quarter. James Cook's tried hard in the ruck and's been pretty good around the ground. Neil Clark's presented well across half forward. And players that have come in and out of the game, the likes of James Forecast, Jake Bromley, Brad Davidson, David Cook and Dean Careys have had patches where they've been very, very good. Chris Hensby and Pat Catt, I think, are the 2 outstanding players for mine. In the opening 3 quarters, both have played 3 really strong quarters of footy. Adam Avard certainly was one of the best players on the ground in the first half, but got his hands on the footy in the third quarter, but just coughed it up on a couple of occasions. Ben Mitchell's also had a terrific tussle, as we've said, with James Cook in the ruck. Taken a couple of big marks, the big fella, but he's let himself down with a couple of out-of-bounders on the full. And the likes of Matthew Vag, Andrew Douglas, Byron Ho and Travis Saw have basically zipped in and out of the match. But for mine at the moment, Chris Hensby and Pat Catt are fighting it out for the gourmet on main and high on fruit best on ground at the moment. And the fact that Pat Cadd has the trophy room solely dedicated to the best on ground awards that we provide, I'm really hoping that Chris Hensby has a big last quarter.
Yeah, absolutely. Cadd's, as you said, Tally,
he's got plenty of them.
He's got plenty of them. So enough's enough.
Enough's enough.
And don't play as well this quarter and we won't give it to you.
Well, I said to, I spoke to his brother yesterday, Ben Cadd, the coach of Pearsdale, of course, and did say to him, Should Paddy Cad be looking like that he's going to get best on ground? I need you to drag him. Because we can't possibly give you another best on ground, give him another best on ground award. So.
Well, Towie, I saw it on, I saw one of them on eBay the other day going for 99 cents with $45 postage and handling. So they're fetching not a bad little price at the moment. So Caddy's just working on potentially another one. But, yeah, look, for me, Hensby is probably one of the best at the moment. If he can pull this quarter together, then I reckon he'll take the chocolates.
Yep, he will. And, well, let's reset and let's get ready to start this last quarter. I reckon Andre Agassi, the former Grand Slam champion, has got the ball in the centre of the ground. He's ready to go. Yeah, just waiting for the siren. It's not the loudest siren you've ever heard, is it?
No, if it wasn't for the umpire holding his hands up in the air to say quarter time and so on and the like.
What's he waiting for? Is he waiting for the TV cameras to
I think he's waiting
lock and load?
I think he's waiting for the ball boy.
He is, to
come across court. And
well, he's confused whether he's a football game or he's playing at centre court in Wimbledon. Thank you, linesman. Thank you, ball boys. I think I heard him just say coming out of his mouth as the ball's back in the centre. Great work there by Fortnum. Jeez, he loves that, doesn't he? Just running under Benny Mitchell. Kicks it up there towards half forward. They come screaming out again. That was Hensby. Hensby kicks the ball. Well, it was off the hands of Hensby. Comes down. Zach De Kluver's got to get a free kick against Paddy Hayden. He's done a pretty good job on him this afternoon, De Kluver. Has not been one of the worst players on the ground from a long, long shot. So, Zach De Kluver, he's not sure where to go. That's a dangerous, dangerous kick. His teammate's got to go for it. That was terrific work there by Bromley. Wonderful work. He ran back with the fly to the foot. He needed to take that mark and did. Goes in short towards Harrington. Great work there by Avard to come in late and try and affect the spoil. They need to kick the first goal of the final quarter. Fortnum goes in short. Hayden versus De Kluver. De Kluver, one grab, two, couldn't get it. Travis Saw comes screaming through. He couldn't take it with him either. It's not him. In fact, it is Tom Frost. Goes to De Kluver. De Kluver, little handball off. Kicks it up wide. Davidson's got to mark the footy. Great work there by Byron Ho from Pearsdale. Taps the ball towards the boundary line. Then eventually it goes over. Right in front of the Jim's Test and Tag commentary booth. Here at Cripp Point. Oh. Ball thrown in. That was the exertion you heard there from the umpire. We've got the umpire mic on this afternoon. The ball goes up towards Neil Clark. Neil Clark keeps the ball in. Good work there by Luke Murray. Taps it forward. Gives it to Fortnum. Fortnum to Avard. That's better play by Avard. Kicks the ball into space, hoping one of his teammates can run onto it. There he is, Frost. Handball out. Goes towards Ben Cadd. There's Hensby again. Hensby has a flying ping at goal. Oh, Hayden kicked his... Just stuck his mid out, Hayden. He probably should have tried to shepherd that one through, but the ball is eventually forced through for a minor score.
Well, Towie, I don't know if you can see, but every time the ball goes down there, it seems to be landing in a pool of water. So I don't know what that that goal square kind of looks like, but I'm thinking it's pretty bad. So just to shepherd it through, it could have gone anywhere.
Jacob Cook to bring the ball back into play. He's a lovely kick of the footy, looking for De Kluver. Hayden got into his back. Umpire said nothing there. Pat Cadd, kick off the ground. Comes down there towards Fortnum. Right foot, snap, goal. Great goal there from Fortnum, and eventually somebody kicks a goal. 7 goals, 11. They are 53, leading Cripp Point 3-7-25. That is on the pest-free scoreboard. You listen to RPP, the voice of Peninsula football.
Don't let rats and mice make your home their home this winter. Hi, I'm Ray Connell, founder and president of Plugging Pest Free since 1995. Did you know the average rat breeds every 3 weeks, producing between 8 to 12 young ones? Rats are also known to chew through electrical wiring in ceilings, and they are responsible for over 25% of electrical fires. Plugging Pest Free, scientifically proven technology, drives them out and keeps them out all year round. For more information, go to pestfree.com.au.
Station sponsor.
3 minutes gone in the final quarter here in the Jim's Test and Tag match of the round. 7-11-53. Pearsdale leading Cripp Point 3-7-25. Ball comes out towards the members' wing. Great work there by Davidson. Kicks the ball up towards half forward. They need a mark. They need something up there, the Magpies.
Something.
But Travis Saw just taps the ball in front of himself. Sloper working hard down there as well. Going in hard there was also young Lockie Marshall. Dave Cook. Little toe poke, only as far as Fortnum. Dodges, weaves, Fortnum. Gives it to Ben Cadd. Ben Cadd now thought about giving it to his brother, but he remembered what I said to him the other day, and that was don't give it to him in the last quarter if he looks like he's going to get best on. Ball comes out wide, looking for Paul Smith. Just a little bit fancy there. Needed to go with the two mitts. He went with just the one, and he overcooked the handball. Puts his teammate under all sorts of pressure. Great work there. McAvag's got to work. Dives on top of it. Paul Smith's second effort. Good. You need to make up for the error before, and he eventually did. Tried to burrow through Vag, and Vag said, listen here, Munchkin. Just get out of my face.
Picked him up and carried
or
him.
Or I'll bite your nose off. As Andre Agassi throws the ball up. Tell me he doesn't look like Andre Agassi. Somebody tell me
I
he
have
doesn't
not
look
corrected
like
you
Agassi.
Yet, because he does.
Ball goes out towards De Kluver. De Kluver gives a little handball out. Went there towards Epichard.
There's been a free. Dropping the ball. Or push.
Yeah, it's a free kick. Dylan Hawes got it. What is he good for?
What is he good for? Absolutely nothing. So say it again.
Dylan Hawes got the footy. He likes his chances from here. He's about 45 metres out. Dylan Hawes, no stranger to kicking goals.
He's going to need to start at the right-hand post, I think, Toey, for it to come back in. Yeah,
and
kicked it left, stayed left.
He started it at the grey ute, and that's where it ended up as well.
The one tonner.
In the back of the tray truck there of the grey ute, and it's through for a minor score. So the Magpies still hanging in there, not sure how. 28 points, 29 points down now, 7 goals, 12-54 to 3-7-25. We've played 5.5 minutes in this final quarter. And it'll be Jacob Cook to bring the ball back in for the Maggies. Wants to play on, does so. Becker just waves his arm around. Goes to Dean Carey's. So they're still in Troublesville.
Yeah.
Down there on the last line of defence.
Still in absolute back pocket.
They are.
Play
he doesn't
on
know
call.
What to do now.
Nah, he needs
gonna,
to kick the ball.
He's going to give it. There it is. He's taken it through the behinds. Now he plays on. And he brings the ball back out, and De Kluver's got the footy. So he goes up the line. It's not De Kluver. I reckon that might be Bromley. Went up towards the wing position. This is better footy from the Magpies.
It is.
Harrington.
Bit too late, though,
slaps the ball forward. Coming out and taking the mark. Here is Clark. He's presented all afternoon, this big bloke, and he's worked his butt off. Kicks it up there towards full forward.
Yeah.
Way, way too strong. And short pass has been screaming to the Magpies all afternoon. Stop stuffing around with the footy. Move the ball quickly and look what might happen.
From the back pocket, Toey, to where it where he's lining up now, three kicks, bang, it's going to result in a goal.
So Flack needs to kick this one. He's sprayed it. He's pushed it across the face. 3 goals, 8-26.
I was willing the gods.
You were. You're also willing Jonathan Flack to kick the goal.
Absolutely.
And he let you down big
he
time.
Did. Big time.
That was also their first inside 50 for this quarter.
Ooh, to how many?
2-4.
Four to Pierce Dale, 1-2 the Magpies in this final quarter. So pest-free scoreboard just taking a while. I think it's just getting long in the afternoon now, and perhaps the fifth, maybe sixth frothy's gone down, and looking at the numbers, and they all look the same, and we just haven't had a scoreboard movement.
I think they're just...
There they are. Finally, it's up. 7 goals, 13. But that's Pearsdale's score. They haven't put Crib Point's score up for this quarter yet.
They're just poking the scoreboard attendant with a stick, Toey, just to wake him up.
They are. 3 goals, 8-26, it should read. Not 3 goals, 7-25. Pearsdale, 7 goals, 13-55. So an even 5 goals, the difference. There's Hensby. There's Pat Cadd. Kicks the ball off the ground. And over the line, and so ineffective kick, so he doesn't get a vote for that.
Because it went out of bounds.
It was a kick off the ground, and it went out of bounds. So, no, he's been terrific today. Patrick Cadd, the leading possession winner on the ground. Dave Lawson not far behind for Crib Point. Ball thrown back into play. Good work there by Cook. Just hacked it out of the air. We're going to go again. No, I thought that Jacob Cook might have gone with it as well. Free kick for hold too high.
No.
The umpire said holding the footy.
Yep.
And the snowman, Frost, will take the free kick at half forward.
Frosty.
So Frost has got the ball at half forward. Kicks the ball across the face, looking for Big Mitchell. Couldn't take the mark for the ball there. The young bloke in Lockie Marshall at the fall of the ball. They all dive on top of it. And the umpire, Agassi, will come in and bounce about 25 metres out directly in front of Crib Point's goal. Pearsdale's goal.
Just not going to get old, that one, Toey.
No, it's not. Good work by Mitchell. Mitchell tapped the ball. Luke Harrington hacks it off the ground. Gets a vital 30 metres in favour of his team. Troy Cunliffe probably should have been over and tried to pick that one up rather than just dribble it. But the ball goes over the line and out of bounds. So we're at half forward for Pearsdale. They lead 55-26. Great work, scoreboard attendant. They've fixed that one up. So they've got that point there. Walked into a wall of trouble there was Byron Ho, but somehow Luke Harrington ends up with a footy, and he's been terrific for them as well. Real four-quarter performer, Luke Harrington. Gave it to Jacob Cook. Left foot kick was nice, but I'd like to see him use that to more effect and boot the ball extremely long inside the attacking zone rather than just going short. Back into play again. Ball thrown in. Ho, left foot kick, kicks it up towards half forward, going back with the flight of it there was Ainsworth. He couldn't get it, comes down to De Kluver, gives it to Jacob Cook. That's a better kick this time, but only as far as Travis Saw, who chips in and takes the mark across half back. Also been a sensational player this afternoon.
It's a very strong up back.
He has, kicks the ball up towards the centre half forward, and that's a terrific mark there by Matthew Vagg. Couldn't do much about that one as he kicks the ball inside looking for Fortnum, and Fortnum takes the mark at half forward. So they're working the ball nicely here, Pearsdale. Caleb Foggy just ran into space, and then also going back there was James Cook. So he's going to unload with a torpedo. Wasn't his best effort. Sprayed it across the face. Dave Lawson attacked the footy hard, and he come in and take a mark. And 50-metre penalty too. So that's against Lockie Marshall for just overstepping the mark. And Dave Lawson, who's got a very, very sore ankle, Dave Lawson.
Yeah, just in the third quarter, Toey, there was a bit of a contest here, and he got up and gingerly walked back to the centre. But, definitely carrying a slight niggle.
So we've played 10.5 minutes into this final quarter. McAvagh got one high. The umpire said, yes, it was there every day of the week. That was sloppy there from Bromley, who's been pretty good this afternoon. So Vag gives it off now towards Frost. Frost kicks the ball long inside 50. They got the numbers here. Crib point. Over the back it goes. De Kluver going hard there to his gamble. He wants the ball. He's still going hard, the big fella. Good work there by De Kluver. Working hard there is Jacob Cook as well. Spills around the corner. Oh, carries. Oh. He dropped it. Goes to Hayden. Hayden gives it to Marshall. Back to Hayden. Hayden gets it smothered off the boot, and eventually it goes over the line out of bounds. So again, sloppy work from the Magpies' defence almost opened up an opportunity for Pearsdale.
They're just looking unorganised down there, Toey. They're panicking. They clearly don't want Pearsdale to score, obviously, but just going about it the wrong way.
So good work there by Fortnum. A quick kick out. Went there towards Carey's. Oh. They dive on top of him. He could get pinged. There's no hair envy there, so says, give it to me.
I'm going to ball it up.
Correct. So we're only about 5 metres, not even. 3 metres out
even.
From Pearsdale's goal. Gamble wants to try and keep that ball in. Plenty of players around the footy at the moment. The umpire will be forced to come in and bounce again.
A lot of numbers around the ball at the moment, Toey. There's, 4-6 players probably from the centre of the ground down towards Cribby's forward line.
Pemberton Buchanan, he dives on, got in the back of his opponent there, Marshall. Little handball out to Knight. Knight to Fortnum's had a big last quarter. How many test and tags for Chris Fortnum?
Fortnum's already had 8 this quarter.
8 this quarter for Chris Fortnum. How many is that for the match?
That is 23.
Ooh, he's right up there then, isn't he? Yeah. Brad Davidson takes the mark as well. Goes out there towards Harrington. Harrington's been very good for the Pies as well today.
He's been the best, Howie.
He has.
The best for Cribby, no doubt.
Goes out towards Sam Adams, and the ball goes over the line and out of bounds. Foggy just finding himself in knee-high in mud. And the ball will be thrown back in. Out of sight of the ground. Half forward line. Pearsdale attacking, as they have for the majority of the 13 minutes of this final quarter. Goes to Sam Adams. Left foot kick. It's a nice one up two towards Harrington. Geez, he's worked hard today. That's a better kick. Kicks it up towards full forward. Sloper over the back. Will it sit for him? Hot on his hammer sore. He's kicked it off his knee. I'm not sure whether it's a goal.
Out.
I'm not sure whether it's a goal. It's hit his knee. It hasn't hit.
He's given it all clear.
It hit his knee. Let's have a look at the replay. Thanks to Gourmet on Main and High on Fruit. And all benefit of the doubt, just below the knee, and the umpire was there and got it right.
I'm just rewinding it back, Towie, just slow-mo, frame by. Yeah, no, look, it's rolled off his knee onto his foot, so that's fantastic, fantastic effort for them, a big fella then.
It was, so Sloper with the biggest number in footy kicks the goal. And, well...
And they're first for nearly a half a football.
It is, too. They did not kick a goal in the third quarter. So up they go again. Gamble got the tap down. Harrington gave away a free kick for in the back. The umpire said play on. Luck's a fortune. Adam Avard took his eye off the footy. Allowed Brad Davidson to get in there. Then he copped one a little bit high. The umpire said, give it to me. I'll restart play here from the baseline because I am Andre Agassi.
He loves a chat, doesn't he? Just as he comes into the play there, he just has a chat to the boys.
He asked him, did you see me beat Pete Sampras in the 1987 Wimbledon final? As the ball goes towards Harrington, gave it to Adams. Adams now from 50, kicks the ball long. It is coming around. You've got the sit at the back of the pack. Lawson off the deck. No. Luke Murray.
Yeah, Murray.
Just slid and made sure that ball went through for a minor score. So they move on to 4 goals, 9:33. Pearcedale 7:13:55. 22 points the difference. We've played 14 and a half in this final quarter. Ball chipped in. Nice. Lockie Marshall finds himself a little bit of space.
They're all just looking a little bit flat, Towie. Not sure if you've noticed, but there's not too much run about the field.
How do they think we feel? We're trying to call it. They're all out there being disinterested. They just want the siren to go. It's cold. It's wet. It's miserable out there. As the ball goes up towards the wing position, that's a lovely mark. Jumar. That was taken by
Foggy.
Campbell. Gives it to
Quick
Foggy.
Legs, Foggy!
There he
Quick
goes.
Legs!
There he goes. He took off at the rate of knots. Oh, the big fella, Benny Mitchell. He worked his team. His opponent under the footy. Pemberton Buchanan.
Keep
the
your
hyphen.
Feet, boys.
Hyphen slid over it. Ben Mitchell is in there as well. Eventually it comes out there to De Kluver.
Harrington, there he is again.
Couldn't get it. Ball goes over the line. Out of bounds. How many for Luke Harrington this afternoon?
20.
So he's had a big last quarter, hasn't he? He's had 6 or 7.
7, yep.
So he's having a big last quarter. The man with all the hair as the ball gets
Plenty
tapped
of.
Down. Sam Adams dodges, weaves, gets out of trouble, kicks it across the face. Dean Carey's takes the mark. Defensive 50 for the Pies.
There he goes. He's loading up, Foggy.
All of a sudden, he goes across the face. You just sense at the moment that the Magpies have got a little bit of a spring
yeah,
in their step.
Yeah, they do.
Pearcedale just playing out the contest. Ball goes in short. Oh. Cook takes the mark. That's James, captain we call
captain.
Him. Former team of the century or team of the year, Ruckman for the MPNFL and the PN League. As the ball gets tapped down, good work by Murray. Hensby it was, little give, kicked it along the boundary line, and the Byron Ho sees it over the line and out of bounds. So Hensby looking the goods at the moment for the best on ground. Gourmet on main and High on Fruit.
Yep, Mark from Gourmet and George from High on Fruit. Go down and see them down at Hastings. They'll look after you down there.
Mark and George.
Mark and George.
George and Mark.
George and Mark.
Here we go again. Trying to trap the footy there. I think it might be Caleb Gray trying to get the footy there. And the ball goes over the line and out of bounds. So are you Mark or are you George? He's Mark.
Mark.
So we mentioned Mark and all of a sudden he appeared
Absolutely.
At the back
door. Absolutely. I think he's been listening the whole time.
So the ball gets tapped in again. Been great sponsors this afternoon.
Absolutely.
Gourmet on main and High on Fruit as the ball comes out towards half forward again. The Magpies pressing. Kicking around the corner. Kicks towards half forward. Flack went for the mark. Couldn't take it. For the ball. Sam Adams doing a power of work in this final quarter. Flack just bustles and builds his way out. Left foot kick was a nice one.
Yeah,
found his teammate. And I reckon that might be the young bloke there in Caleb Gray who's got the mark about 35 metres out. Slight angle.
He's...
This will be two in a row for the Pies.
He's just he's coming in from a long way out, Towie. That's a blood rule.
So there is a blood rule, is it? Who's that? Andrew Douglas is being sent from the field. So somebody else is going to come and have to stand the mark. But this will be two in a row for them if we can kick the goal, which will be good work. Be fantastic work for the Pies to finish with a flurry. All of a sudden, it's nothing in it.
Absolutely.
Ass.
It's 18-minute mark of the fourth. If they can kick this goal, obviously, umpire's just called time on again. So he's
Well, he's got to kick this one. The young run from the Stingrays. It's not a great effort. Goes across the face. Couldn't take the mark down there. Pressure's on. All over him they are down there. Is he going to get pinged for holding the ball? Sloper wanting the free kick. Just trying to barge his way out. Just trying to give the ball to Harrington. So here it is. I'm presenting it on a platter. Just take it from me and run off. And he didn't. Neil Clark. Jump before acceptances. Cad with a little kick off the ground. Hall got thrown off. It. Didn't have the footy. Umpire said no. Comes to Adams. Bounced it like a basketball. Finally gives it out. The umpire's found a free kick.
No.
Give it back to me, boys. We'll restart play. There's Lawson pumping the boys
pumping them up. Come on.
Come on, boys, he's saying. Ball comes out. Nobody can get it out. It's a lot of congestion.
Yeah, a lot, Tony.
Eventually comes out to David Cook. Little left foot kick came from Jansen, only as far as Lawson.
Play on's a call.
Lawson gone for holding the footy, and that's a great tackle there from, it was coach on coach there, Ben Cadd versus Dave Lawson. And Crib Point have certainly lifted a notch in the last 5 minutes since their goal. Pearcedale need to stem the flow. They need to kick the next one. This man's been terrific.
Yeah,
presented all day. Matthew
quarter.
Flagg.
Especially the last quarter.
So Vag's got the ball. Goes out wide. This is another bloke who's had heaps of it in this last quarter. Fortnum looking 50. For 50 and he's going to get it. Silly play there by Paul Smith. Just didn't need to lay that bump on Chris Fortnum and he milked it for everything it was worth.
Oh, yeah, he took the dive. But like you said, Towie, just no need for it. Late in the last quarter, the boys are willing each other to just put a couple of majors on the board and then to go and do something like that, just silly.
20 minutes gone, final quarter. Chris Fortnum.
Great game, Fortnum.
Has kicked a goal in this last quarter.
Sprayed
make
it.
That. One goal in this last quarter. One goal, one. What did you see, Kingy?
Bit of water.
Bit of water.
Yeah.
There's like a little lake down there.
That is, Towie. Kingy, just some wood ducks down there. Just got interrupted.
7:14 to 4:09. Hope they weren't exercising the option down there, the ducks. The ball comes out towards half forward.
Barrel.
Goes, was the big Baz too. Fortnum's got a massive chance again here. Comes in towards Becker, right foot snap around the corner. Mitchell couldn't take the mark in the last in the goal square. Comes down there towards Pat Cadd. Don't let him kick it as the ball gets kicked over the line and through for a minor score. So Pat Cadd has not kicked a goal this afternoon. Chris Fortnum's kicked a goal in the last quarter, as has Matt Sloper. So just the two goals coming in this final quarter. The ball's at half back. De Kluver gives a little handball off, looking for Jansen. Couldn't find him. Comes to Carey. Sweeping handball there towards... that was Jacob Cook. Comes towards Edwards now. Edwards tries to get a kick up towards the wing position. He needs a teammate to go. He did. That was David Cook. Eventually the ball goes over the line. No, kept in play there by Vag. Eventually now it's over the line and out of bounds. We've played 21 and a half minutes into... this final quarter of footy in the Jim's Test and Tag Match of the Day. Pest-free scoreboard sees Pearcedale 7:15:57 to Crib Point 4:09:33. 24 points the difference. John Flack, he attacks the footy hard on the diving on the ball there was Andrew Douglas. They're all calling for a free kick and they didn't get one.
Yeah,
that's the Magpies. Good work there by Gamble. Got the tap in front of Cook. Goes out the back. Douglas running onto it now. Oh. Falls over. He tripped over his own shoelaces there. Kingy liked that one. Nothing funnier than watching somebody fall over by themselves.
No.
Chris Hensby just pointing out a few things. Directing some traffic. Gamble versus Cook.
I want you there.
Cook gets it. There's a free kick. It's going to go to James Cook. No. Is it?
Captain.
No. It's going to Sammy Adams.
Adams.
So Sam Adams has got the footy for the Magpies. Far too... out too far to score. Comes out there. Towards the young fella in Caleb Gray. He dives on top of it. Trying to pull it out. Going in there's Davidson. With the pre-locks. We think that he's just got the pre-dreadlocks at the moment, Brad Davidson.
I think he's better off putting in some hair extensions, Towie, because that's just not, not cutting the mustard at the moment.
Dives on top of it. Foggy's on top of him. Speak of the devil in Brad Davidson. He gets up last, throws the umpire the footy. That's umpire Andre Agassi, of course. Mentioned him a few times this afternoon.
Yeah.
As the ball comes down towards Harrington, he's besieged upon there by Foggy and Fortnum. And the umpire will be forced to come in and bounce again. 23 and a half minutes gone. Only the two goals kicked in this final quarter, so you wouldn't expect it to go too long. There was some time on for a blood rule, though.
Mm-hmm.
Comes down to Foggy.
Foggy.
Couldn't get his hands on it. Chris Hansby gets another possession. Kicks it up. Wasn't his greatest effort. Chipping in, taping a mark there was Jaden Eppenchild.
Eppenchild.
So Eppenchild now kicks the ball inside 50. Needs a big mark. Ben Mitchell was terrific.
Here we go.
There he is. Johnny Flack went for the left foot banana. And, there's a player down there. That looks like Travis Saw, I reckon. Yeah. It is. Just winded, I reckon, in that contest.
Yeah, just grabbed his knee for a minute there. And I thought, oh, we're in strife. Saw.
Byron Ho, he kicks the ball up the line. Finds Dean Jansen. So Dean Jansen's got the footy. Just happy to keep possession of the footy at the moment. Goes across the face. Looking for Luke Murray. So there's quite a few dreadlocks out here this afternoon.
I walked into the canteen. Well, not into it, but I got my hot dog and chips. And there was a bloke there that resembled Bob Marley. And he had the dirtiest, greatest, biggest dreadies you've ever seen. And I think one of them went in my hot dog.
Pat Cad's got the footy now. Pat Cad's got the footy. On the wing position.
Dreadies.
He kicks the ball to half forward. Didn't he have a cap on?
No.
No cap.
No, nothing will fit in. Hairnet won't carry that.
He needs a potato bag just to put over the top of the dough. I mean, that's a great kick on the ground. Almost kicked a goal there was Gavin Becco. Rolled and rolled and rolled, but Dean Carey stopped it. What's going on here? The umpire's bringing it back. And why is he bringing it back?
I think because the umpire hadn't waved his flag.
Yeah, but when Crip Point kicked the goal earlier in this quarter, the umpire hadn't even reached for his stick and they brought the ball back in play. And they kicked a goal. And Matt Sloper kicked a goal. So Dean Carey's has got the footy at fullback.
Moving on. Play on's a call.
Play on is the call. He goes in short looking for and finding De Kluver. So Zach De Kluver has been terrific for the Pies all afternoon.
Yeah, it has been.
Worked very, very hard. Kicks the ball up the line. Sloper comes down. He's got a couple to beat.
Oh, he's angry.
Yeah, he does. He competes very, very well, Matty Sloper. Ball in there. Pemberton Buchanan tried to barge his way out, but Paddy Hayden wasn't letting him get anywhere and
holds the footy up.
Gourmet on main, high on fruit. Mark from Gourmet and George from high on fruit. They're at the ground. They're at the ground, ready for their photo opportunities this afternoon.
I think they are. He's sporting the gourmet on main top and cap, looking a treat. I think he had a can in his hand, just a soft drink, I would assume.
Oh yes, definitely.
Yeah, definitely a soft drink.
Just come straight from work and
yeah. Because we don't drink and drive.
No, we don't. As the ball goes across the face, good work there. That was from Jaden Eppenchild.
But
there's
back.
The siren.
Oh, it is too.
There's the siren. It went 26 and a half minutes. And Pearsall have run out winners. 7-16, 58 have defeated Crib Point. 4-10, 34 And yes, there's Warren.
Who won?
Uncle Warren.
Who won the footy?
Pearsall won the footy, Uncle Warren.
I want a good point, Magpie!
Yes, we know you break for the Magpies, Uncle Warren.
Go to Magpie!
Yes, Uncle Warren. We'll go to a break and we'll be back with a full-time wrap. You're listening to RPP, the voice of Peninsula Football. Kingy has lost it.